Hello learners, today in this class I am going to discuss with you about education of the disadvantaged children from the block 502. Here in this chapter I am mainly going to focus on education of the girls. All of us know about the neglect of girl child in general and undesirable attitude that many have towards their education in particular. Both in the family and community and at the school, the education of the girls is usually not taken very seriously. Such endemic neglect can be found in any part of our country, irrespective of the financial status of the family. Nearly half of the child population and potential future mothers are given casual treatment so far as the basic and foundation education is concerned. Why girls' education is important? Learners, you may have heard about the proverb saying that by educating a boy, an individual is educated. But when a girl is educated, a generation is educated. So goes a proverb which captures the importance of girls' education. Besides educating half of the child population, girls' education has more return in real terms, particularly in the cases towards women empowerment, education and efficiency in working place, removal of gender equity, then family health and education, improved child care, fertility rate and economic growth. While the apathy towards girl child's education begins in the family, it is also continuing in different forms in the schools and classroom. Some issues of girls' education in school are access and enrollment, unfavorable school climate, and discriminatory practices. Opportunity of having a school nearer to the habitation of a child is still lacking in remote rural areas and in hilly terrains. Families do not like to send the girls to a school situated at a distant place, or if the approach to the school is considered unsafe either due to difficult geographical conditions such as hilly track, water bodies, forest, uneven landforms, etc., or due to the presence of unsocial elements on the way to school. Enrollment of girls in the primary school has improved considerably during the last decades due to the persistent efforts made through the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan in all states of the country. But the enrollment of girls across the states lags behind those of the boys. The reason for this phenomenon are many, like engaging girls in domestic chores, taking care of younger siblings, or because of lack of awareness of the utility of education of girls. Now, what about the unfavorable school climate? While several infrastructure inadequacies like lack of required number of classrooms, small and crowded classrooms, rooms without adequate light, and the absence of toilet and drinking water facilities create uncomfortable situation for all learners, both boys and girls, lack of separate toilet and water facilities are considered most unfavorable conditions for girl students in the school. Some discriminatory practices are also done in case of the girls. Knowingly or unknowingly, we usually give less attention to the girls' education and other problems they face in the school and the classroom. In the classroom, the girls sit separately away from the boys. In group work, girls sit in separate groups. Girls are not engaged to perform learning activities as frequently as boys in the classroom. The girls are asked less number of questions than the boys during the classroom interactions are some of the discriminatory practices that are continuously done in our schools. Some myths about learning performances are also there. There are several common beliefs about girls' learning achievements. Some of such beliefs I can tell you here are: girls are poor achievers than the boys at any age or grade level. This is a concept that we people are having in this country about the girls' achievement in comparison to the boys. Girls are poor performers in mathematics at any level than the boys. Girls perform better in language, literature, and poetry than the boys. Girls are better in verbal fluency and artistic aesthetic sensibilities, whereas boys are better in mathematical reasoning and physical motor abilities. How to tackle these issues? Continuous interaction with parents, especially with the mothers, is to be made for the enrollment and regular attendance and performance of girl children. You can take several steps in this regard in your school also. Some suggestions I can give you related to some points for attaining the above mentioned objective. First is the community mobilization. Continuous interaction with parents, especially with the mothers, is to be made for the enrollment, regular attendance and performance of girl children. The members of the school managing committee, mother teacher association, self-help groups and other opinion makers should be sensitized for mobilizing communities in favor of girls' education in their respective schools. In this direction, you should take the initiative first. You can ensure separate toilets for the girls. Using available funds from Sarva Siksha Abhiyan, separate toilets need to be constructed. You must see that the girls use it properly following all sanitary habits. This not only helps in regular attendance of the children, it also develops sound sanitation habits in them which they also carry to their families. Availability of incentives in time. Dear learners, girls in schools are being provided with several incentives like free school uniforms, free textbooks and free reading and writing materials from the Sarva Siksha Abhiyan funds. You need to ensure that these incentives reach to them on time. Next is involving girls in all activities. Dear learners, you need to specially ensure the participation of girls in all types of activities conducted in schools. No activity should be specifically marked only for boys or only for girls. Then more group learning. Dear learners, you must create more scope for group and peer learning in which girls can participate without any restriction. Such free and purposeful group interactions help in minimizing gender discrimination in the classroom. Then bias-free classroom interaction. During classroom interactions, you must distribute your questions nearly in equal manner among boys and girls, consciously avoid giving any discriminatory remarks to girls and encourage them for better performance. Then bias-free learning assessment. Dear learner, you need not attach any bias or discrimination while assessing the learning progress of girls. The girls should not have any feeling of unfairness in assessment of their performance. You may encourage peer assessment as a part of formative assessment in which every child, including the girl child, feels free to assess others and herself simultaneously, thus getting motivated to improve her performance. Now, what about the girls' education? What Sarva Siksha Abhiyan is doing for girls' education in our country? Girls' education is one of the major interventions of Sarva Siksha Abhiyan. It recognizes that reaching out to the girl child is central to the efforts to universalize elementary education. Sarva Siksha Abhiyan's focus on gender parity is rooted in the National Policy on Education 1986 and also National Policy on Education 1992 and the Program of Action, which brought in center stage the issues of gender and girls' education. More importantly, it linked education of women and girls to their empowerment. National Policy on Education states that education should be a transformative force, but women's self-confidence and improve their position in society is challenge inequalities. That's all for today. Thank you very much.